Okay, so this is the parts rig. That's the running rig. The same color. I think this one here, the hood, has just got a couple of minor... Well, I don't... Yeah, there's a ding right here. Hail ding. The leading edge is good. Cedar stuff on. Yeah, there's a ding right here. Yeah, there's a couple here, some more hail dings. Anyway, this rig has got some hail dings in it. The fender flares are all good. This one actually has mud flaps. I always intended on taking these mud flaps off the front of this and putting them on this one here, so you can see how it sprays mud up the side of the rig, you know. And of course, these tires aren't even aggressive. I mean, it's got street tread. Good tires. They've been on here. I probably only put a couple thousand miles on them. I don't know how many. They look almost new still. I haven't rotated them or done anything since I bought the rig. He had them on there. He was driving it daily back and forth to work until the transmission went out. I bought it with the bad transmission. And then this one, my cousin bought it new and said he blew the motor up through a rod through the block. I really had never got down. I've never noticed a hole in the block, but anyway, that's what he said. And I haven't really inspected it any. It sat at his house for many years. He was going to fix it. And the white hard top on that rig came off of this one. That has the black Targa top on it right still. I never did swap them out. This rig has got the white Targa top. But here is the soft top that came off of the running one. And it's in pretty good shape. I think there's a snap or two broke, and I think the zipper in the back on the back door had an issue. Nothing too bad. It didn't really leak. But I want the hard top. I mean, it, you know. But anyway, this does have the key for this rig that fits all the doors and everything. Ignition and doors all match. The running rig, I don't know. The key only fits the ignition. I've been meaning to see about either getting a key made for the doors or swapping, you know, to pulling the key locks out of this one and putting it in that one, depending on, you know, how much it costs to get a key made for the doors on that rig. But so you got an option. This hood I was going to show. This hood's in not the best shape. It's got a dent there. It's got a ding here where they look like, I don't know what that would have been from. But other than that, it's a pretty good, I think the leading edge on this one's okay. But it's got a couple of, it's probably in worse shape than the other one. Both the bodies are pretty straight all in all. Not much issue with the bodies. And, of course, now I only have the one. This back glass came out of that rig over there. And anyway, you got a zippered back window and the soft top. I did this. This is the only damage that really has happened since I've owned it, and it clears the door good. It didn't really hurt the door. It kind of bent it right here on the bottom edge a little bit, but it doesn't really affect it. Somebody had a trailer on it. I guess a trailer hitch. I don't think I did that. But anyway, it's got a couple of dings in it. I put this receiver, these are grade 8 bolts, and I made this, because you can't find a receiver. I couldn't find a receiver tube to fit this hitch, and they didn't seem to make a receiver for these. They're pretty light and really can't tow a whole lot with it. I pulled my little 10-foot trailer with a camper box on it, and, you know, it was a pretty heavy little rig. I mean, it wasn't super heavy, probably maybe 2,000 pounds. I don't even know. Nah, it wouldn't even be that much. But it did a pretty good job of towing it up the hill, but I did use the low range just to keep from putting a load on anything. But anyway, it does have a receiver because I used the hitch haul. I had a little box that I carried on the back, and that's the reason I wanted the receiver, because I used my hitch haul to haul tools and stuff. That's mainly what I've used this rig for. I've run it on the highway. It'll do pretty good. you know, it'll run 70, 80 mile an hour down the highway. It turns quite a few RPMs at that speed, but and it's kind of noisy inside. But the guy I got it from, he was driving it from Mulberry to Fort Smith every day, back and forth to work. And he did this, busted this turn signal. It still works, but he did that damage. He said he started it up and had it running, and it rolled down a hill and hit something. But this one's good on this rig. I've got this, of course, this, both of them have all four wheels. And then I've got, these are the two off of this one. And this one will come with a spare. I have the tire, a Rocky factory wheel cover. This has actually got the factory hubcaps on this one also, in good shape. So between the, it's a really nice example of a Rocky. And you know, this tail light's cracked here. Everything works. I never noticed any moisture issues. But this tail light's in excellent shape. If a person wanted to, you could swap this tail light. The transmission is in back of here that came out of the running rig, and it's a you know, I don't think there's much wrong with it. It just didn't go in any gear. You could hear everything turning inside the transmission. You rev the engine up, you could hear a light ticking sound. And well, I'm not gonna pop the hood on the, well, I guess I ought to pop the hood on the bad one, but oh, I'm getting kind of long in the tooth here. I'm gonna stop this video. I've got the battery covered just to make sure it doesn't short against the hood. But anyway, yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and stop this video before it gets any longer. We got both mirrors on both Rockies, I think, are in good shape. I think I've got one or two spare starters that I have bought off of eBay. One of them is supposed to be new. This door handle's broke on this one. I say new, supposed to be rebuilt. I bought it from a remanufacturing, they were closing down a business. And I think that's what's sitting in the seat here is that starter. And then I believe there's at least one other starter. I've got some extra wheels, but they do fit my 10-foot trailer, so we'll just have to see. I'm not going to say that they'll go with, but you will get a spare on the running rig, and then of course a rolling chassis for the, if you buy the extra one, because I'm not selling them together. You'll have to I'll make a deal on both, but it just kind of depends on how, what a person wants, you know, if they're looking for just a runner or if they're wanting parts. You know, these aren't exactly, they only made them for 3 years, so, or well, they only sold them in the U.S. for 3 years. I keep saying they only made them. They've made them, they still make, I think Dodge, who still sells, makes vehicles, but they just don't sell them in the United States.